Hi guys, Intel has announced the new processors which will come out on 24 of this month, five models in total. The name scheme is totally changed. Obviously they didn't want to follow the previous naming scheme. Intel Core Ultra 9 285K, it's the top with 24 cores and threads. There is no hyperthreading anymore. Price $590. And it's followed by Ultra 5 and Ultra 7 models with 20 cores and threads and 14 cores and threads. The prices look good. I think that Intel in these 2-3 generations was hitting on the prices. They are pretty good. On the contrary, the AMD CPUs, the prices are going up all the time. First of all, we found the processors and the mainboard. I'm waiting for them to test them, to fully evaluate them. And especially, I want to take power measurements. There's something going on, as I hear, with the new processors. They don't seem to draw so much power from the EPS connectors, so it is difficult to take accurate power measurements out of them. The thing is that the ATX, the 24-pin cable, only has a limited number of 20-volt gauges, so it cannot deliver high power without melting these cables. So I don't know why these new processors don't use so much the EPS connectors. Anyway, once I have the samples in hand, I will put Powernetix to the job and see what is going on there. After all, my main job is in the power analysis section. Not only, but I like it more. Another thing that I hear is that performance is not that good, guys. And this is troublesome for me. So far, Intel had very good performance. The thing is that the high performance came with high power consumption. Now, the new processors don't seem to be up to the bar that AMD set in gaming, especially in gaming performance. This is not good. This is not good at all, because if these new processors are a major failure for Intel, it will be really, really bad for the business. Intel is not going so well lately. Everybody knows that. And imagine a possible scenario where Intel is in deep trouble and we only have AMD. In the past, Intel had the monopoly, give or take, with AMD trying to catch up. Now we have AMD way ahead, or with a serious advantage, and Intel is trying to catch up. So if things go way wrong with Intel and we are only left with AMD, we will have about the same situation that we have in GPUs with Nvidia. Nvidia doesn't give a damn now for releasing any new desktop GPUs. They say that the RTX 5090 will be released somewhere in January, and it's more than 2 years time that we have the previous, the 4000 GPU generation. Because Nvidia doesn't care, is on top. So they say, as long as I'm the best at the top performance, why bother to release something better? If something similar happens to the CPU area, it won't be good, right? Moreover, what I don't like is that it seems that IT technology, in at least in the consumer market, has reached a bar that it's very, very difficult to go over it. And let me explain about that. We all seen the AMD Ryzen 9000 CPUs. Okay, the performance difference was very low compared to the 7000, especially the 7000 X3D processors. And AMD tried to say that, okay, we used the new Windows edition update, which was officially out yet, and this is why the viewers got different results from our results. The performance difference was low, and this was a huge problem. Something similar happens with the new Intel CPUs. Imagine, I'm just saying out of my mind, imagine if the new Nvidia GPU comes out, the RTX 5090, and the performance difference with the 4090 is not that large. Then we will be in huge trouble, guys. I don't know. Things look to have slowed down a lot in the IT technology. I don't know why, but this is the case in the CPUs. Hopefully, it won't be the case in GPUs because it's 2 years since the last NVIDIA GPU release. We'll see. I know. I would like to hear your thoughts about that in the comments. And hwbastards.com. Go there and read all the articles. That's all. Bye-bye.